You're listening to Continuing Coverage, The Key Bridge Collapse. Here is Torrey Snow, WBAL News Radio 1090 and FM 101.5.
All right, so we've been talking a great deal about the collapse of the Key Bridge. I woke up to the news wondering, is this real? I see the alerts. And yeah, I know you're not supposed to check your phone first thing in the morning, but I do, right? Because I want to be prepared for the show. And looking into it, a cargo ship crashed into one of the pylons of the Key Bridge. The bridge subsequently collapsed. Here's some police audio from that.
313 dispatch. The whole bridge just fell down. Everybody. The whole bridge just collapsed.
10-4 dispatch is direct.
That's correct. This time. Do we know if all traffic was stopped?
I can't get to the other side, sir. The bridge is down. We're going to have to get somebody on the other side of the Anne Arundel County MSP to get up here and stop traffic coming northbound on the Key Bridge.
C-13, I'm holding all traffic northbound.
Yeah, you know, I mean, look, as we look at everything that's transpired, it's been a frustrating day. I found the news to be extremely discouraging. But one bright spot about this is the fact that our first responders, the collaboration of our officials working together. I just thought it was interesting that the second this went down, they said, we need to get someone from Anne Arundel County to help us out with this, you know, chaotic situation that's unfolding. And it just kind of speaks to the importance of collaboration and partnership. Joining us now is the county executive for Anne Arundel County, County Executive Steuart Pittman. And County Executive Pittman, thanks for joining the program. I will just kind of ask you, just kind of starting things off, how did you find out about this incident? What was your initial reaction when you first heard about it?
Thanks for getting me on, Torrey. I got a call from the mayor at about 2 a.m. Knew it wasn't good when I got a call at that hour. I just coincidentally happened to have woken up. So and he told me what it was briefly. Then I got a call from Johnny O. Then I got a call from Governor Moore. Had to decide whether to go up there. I decided to stay out of the fray. The fire department was going up. The police department was going up. We had 3 fireboats. One is still up there with the dive team, and then our police were helping with traffic. So immediate coordination, our Office of Emergency Management set itself up to be on call to do anything that was necessary. At that point, they didn't know whether there was terrorist activity or what it was. And then I went up there this morning and checked in with our folks. And was there when the governor did his press conference and really got to see the whole operation with all of the agencies. And you're absolutely right. It's about coordination.
Yeah. And actually, so point of clarification, I'm just curious, were Anne Arundel County officers involved with the original incident? I know we were listening to police dispatch. Were Anne Arundel County officers in the region helping with that when it first happened?
Well, they were not the ones who got the initial call and went and stopped traffic and saved some lives in the process. They were asked to come up and help with traffic management early on.
Yeah. And so you did, and you kind of made reference to the ways in which Anne Arundel County provided assistance in the recovery. And you mentioned that. So the fire department was clearly involved. And then you mentioned boats. Do we have county boats?
Yes. Oh, yes, we do. We have fire boats and then one, you know, carries the dive crew.
Okay.
And that one's still up there. So yeah, we have 3 that are part of the fire department.
All right. So I guess given the way that this has all gone down, obviously there's going to be a lot of discussion about how to move forward. How do you see this whole incident impacting Anne Arundel County?
Well, you know, it's the beltway. It's 695 that goes around Baltimore City, and it goes through Anne Arundel County. It goes through Brooklyn Park in the northern part of the county. And so a lot of people get on 695 to go places, to go east and north, in particular, is where they can't go anymore. So it's going to be, for some people, a major inconvenience. We're lucky that we have the tunnels as alternatives. Obviously, if you're driving a truck that's got, you know, flammables and propane and things, you can't go through tunnels and you have to go all the way around the beltway. But you know, that's the traffic impact. And I'll say that we don't know quite how it's going to be until school comes back in. School being out this week does reduce traffic flow a fair amount, a lot.
Right. And so that's going to be a factor. And so I guess kind of looking forward, what is your office looking as far as strategic planning? You know, because obviously we have no idea how long the port's going to be closed. We don't know how long the bridge is going to be out. What are some of the things that your team is thinking about from a long-term planning perspective?
Yeah, well, fortunately, the state transportation manages that kind of major traffic flow and really did get on it quickly. So people knew about it quickly, and then they're doing everything they can to make sure that alternatives are open and available, and they're going to try to do some things with transit if that helps. You know, there's a big psychological impact. We think of the Key Bridge people who use it as it's sort of part of our infrastructure, and when it's destroyed like that, it's kind of, I mean, I almost feel like there's this weird hole, you know.
Yeah.
And you go up there and you see it, and it's the loss is kind of real. What everybody's worried the most about is economic impact beyond the loss of life that we don't know yet. But, you know, some six missing workers who are up there filling potholes are the ones who are still being searched for. And we'll know soon what they whether they think they can survive this long. So there's that. But then the economic impact really depends on how soon they can get that channel reopened for the ships to get in and out of the port.
Certainly. And, you know, obviously we're looking for partnerships at the state and federal level. I guess I'm wondering, as the recovery goes in, the state's going to be involving, what do you envision Anne Arundel County's partnership will look like as bigger pieces move into play here?
You know, it is that sort of first response where we're the most involved. From there, it's really being part of any advocacy that's necessary to get federal support. Clearly, the president has come out and said it's all there, and the feds are likely to cover all the costs of rebuilding the bridge. So, you know, there may be conversations about planning if there's anything different about the bridge that gets built that we would be involved in. But I suspect that what gets built there is going to be exactly where it is. You know, it's part of the Beltway. It's part of 695. And similar to what's there, obviously, it's going to be stronger and it's going to last a good long time. But those kinds of conversations about what gets built is where we'd be involved.
Well, County Executive, thank you so much for joining the program. And on behalf of our listeners, please pass our gratitude along to all the first responders that are involved, the dive teams, the fire department, police, anyone who's involved in that effort. Please thank them on our behalf for the incredible response in this situation. And we'll probably be in touch as we move into the next phases of this. Have a fantastic afternoon, sir.
All right. I will do that. Thank you, Torrey.
All right. That was County Executive Steuart Pittman. He's the county executive for Anne Arundel County, and you know, there's a lot of parts that are involved here. I did think it was interesting that he pointed out that, you know, the county's role is really that local response, which is, again, it brings me to that all politics is kind of local. That's a really, really important part of our response. We'll talk a little bit more about the response when we get back, the heroic efforts of our first responders. I'm Torrey Snow, WBAL.